Good morning, dear friends, brothers and sisters in the Lord. Welcome to our worship today. God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. I praise God that even when we do not see each other in person, God works in mysterious ways. He is in our midst. And let us open our hearts and give God the glory, honor, and praise. May we all be blessed as we seek His presence at this hour. Let us gather now and worship the Lord. Let us pray. As your children come to praise you and declare your mighty name, O God, let your Spirit fall upon us, that we may see ourselves as your instruments to serve people and bring your love and peace to the world. Amen. Let us continue in our worship by singing our song, which is in our screen at this time.
Father in heaven, how we love you. We lift your name in all the earth. May your kingdom be established in our praises. As your people, we declare your mighty works. Blessed be the
For our scripture reading, let us prepare our hearts as we listen to Sister Odilia Acquo.
Our reading today is from the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 1 verse 1 to 10. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy, to the church of the Thessalonians in God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace to you and peace. We always give thanks to God for all of you and mention you in our prayers, constantly remembering before our God and Father your works of faith and labor of love and steadfastness of hope in our Lord Jesus Christ. For we know, brothers and sisters, beloved by God, that he has chosen you, because our message of the gospel came to you not in words only, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit, with the full conviction, just as you know what kind of people we proved to be among you for your sake. And you became imitators of us and of the Lord, for in spite of persecution, you received the word with joy, inspired by the Holy Spirit, so that you become an example to all the believers in Macedonia and in Achaia. For the word of the Lord has sounded forth from you not only in Macedonia and Achaia, but in every place where your faith in God has become known, so that we have no need to speak about it. For the people of those regions report about us what kind of welcome we had among you, and how you turned to God from idols to serve a living and true God, and to wait for his Son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead, Jesus, who rescued us from the wrath that is coming. The word of God for God's people. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Before hearing the message for today, let us listen to a message of song to be rendered to us by the Baluyot and Marker family.
If you're holding a sadness and life feels undone,
when the mountains loom larger and darken your days,
there's a place of redemption and grace. Look to the all-forgiving cross. See what the Savior has done. Look to the all-forgiving cross. All is provided for us. There is rest for your soul, shelter from every storm, as you embrace the forgiving cross. The
hope for the hopeless, a strength for the weak. For your burdens are lifted and replaced with his peace.
So remember the price that was paid on that day. It was worth giving all for your sake. Look to the all-forgiving cross. See what the Savior has done. Look to the all-forgiving cross. All is provided for us. There is rest for your soul, shelter from every storm, as you embrace the forgiving.
Praise God for that rendition of a beautiful song. And thank you very much, dear Baliot and Marker family, for always there, willing and available to share the gift God gave you. So God bless you all. There are some experiences in this life that are so amazing and remarkable that you just have to talk to someone about them. Yes, I'm going to be a dad. We're going to have a baby. And after 5 years, now this is it. So what an exciting thing to share. And also, you say, yes, I passed the board exam. I finally got it all done. And you want to share that experience and those moments, how you'll be able to put all things together. Sometimes you hear a song on the radio, read a book, watch a movie, or something that is so striking that you can't help yourself. And that's when it's clear that it really has made an impression on you. And what happened when Paul and his fellow evangelists came to Thessalonica, made that kind of impression, not only on the people who heard and believed the gospel, but also on people all over the place. And that is the meaning of what Paul says in verse 8. The Lord's message rang out from you, not only in Macedonia and Achaia. Your faith in God has become known everywhere. And what people were talking about wasn't just the new church, but the way it had come into being. People were talking about the amazing infectious effect the gospel had. And at the heart of it was the call to worship the one true God rather than idols. And this was simply unheard of in Paul's time, in his world. It would be like asking people today to give up using the cars or their cars, computers, TVs, and cell phones, iPads. The gods of Greek and Roman paganism were everywhere. For example, if you were going to plant a tree, you would pray to the relevant God. If you were going on business trip, visit to the right place, right shrine, and offer your offerings. If your son or daughter were getting married, a serious and expensive worship of a deity or God was expected of you. At every turn in the road, the gods were there, unpredictable, possibly mean, and dangerous, sometimes at war among themselves. And in particular, there was one new and recent arrival among the gods of Greece and Rome. When Augustus defeated his rivals and became emperor of Rome and all its lands, he declared that his adopted father, Julius Caesar, had become a god. Can you imagine? And right into the middle of this crazy world came three unknown Jews, Paul, Silas, and Timothy, telling these pagans that there was only one true God, and that this God had a son, and that son had been raised from the dead. Nobody had ever said anything like that before. And the people in Thessalonica, knowing right from the beginning the huge risk they would be taking, turned away from their idols to this living God, and in doing so, discovered at the same moment both suffering and joy. And that is what conversion is all about. It is what happens when someone stops going in one direction, turns around, and begins going in the opposite direction. Has this happened to you? A story is told about a group of old friends hanging out and having a conversation. One of them had recently become a Christian. His old buddies were giving him a bit of a hard time and said, "You don't really believe all these miracle stories in the Bible, do you?" One guy said. And in response, his friend replied, "I don't know about the miracle stories in the Bible, but I do know about a miracle story in my own life. Since giving my life to the Lord, Jesus has changed beer into furniture. It is a sight to see when someone gives their life to Christ. The transformation which takes place is indeed nothing short of a miracle. And transformation continues as we become involved in a community of faith, volunteer our time, learn the joy of giving to God, and becoming close friends, like family really, with our brothers and sisters in the faith. The Christians in Thessalonica had only been believers for a short time. We didn't know exactly how long, but it can't have been more than a year. But already, people from hundreds of miles around were talking about this unheard thing. Very ordinary people were doing something extraordinary in response to an unexpected message. The only explanation was that the living God was at work through the message of Jesus Christ. The Thessalonican Christians had become imitators of the Lord, even in the face of suffering or severe sufferings at its worst. Talk about courage. Talk about commitment. Talk about a mighty, mighty God. And even in the midst of their suffering and persecution, they were filled with joy by the power of the Holy Spirit. And so, other people became curious and wanted to know what they had discovered. What have they got that I don't have? And through their imitation of Christ, others began to imitate them. In Macedonia, in Achaia, the Lord's message was ringing out from them. "Your faith has become known everywhere," Paul proclaims. "When something is good and something is real, word gets around. And I think word is getting around about you folks as well. I think that the community surrounding our church is beginning to sit up and take notice. When Christians begin to live out with deep conviction the calling of Christ, the life of Christ, the way of love and generosity through Christ, and the power of the Holy Spirit, people can't help out but notice that the real thing has arrived. You can't help but to share that the real thing has arrived. We live in a society so engulfed in idols. We may not call them gods nor pray to them, but actions speak itself. Actions speak so. When we spend money on ourselves without thinking of our hungry neighbor next door, we're making idols out of ourselves. When we concentrate our efforts on building better things for ourselves, rather than spending time, talent, and money going out to those who do not know Christ, we are worshiping idols. But when we give sacrificially so that others can eat, when we knock on doors and offer a free cup of water or whatever, when we engage in random acts of kindness, when we become peacemakers and reconcilers, when we seek to heal, help, and restore, when we offer Christ in these ways, when we not become judges, and we instead become lovers, we are truly worshiping the one true and living God, and that is exciting. It is exciting not only for us, but for those who hear about us. And the deeds of love done for others in Christ's name become music to the ears of the lost, the hurt, the hungry. This was happening in a brand new church during Paul's time, which had never seen anything like this before. And no wonder Paul was delighted to write to them, "We continually remember before our God and Father your work produced by faith, your labor prompted by love, and your endurance inspired by hope. For the people living all around them, even folks living hundreds of miles away, tell how they turned to God from idols to serve the living and true God, whom he raised from the dead, Jesus who rescues us. May the same be said of you and me, dear brothers and sisters, here at Grace UMC, and all churches, especially where you are. May God be praised, and may God be shared. God bless us all. Amen." I invite you now all to share our gifts, our offerings to the Lord. Let us now respond to God by sharing what God has blessed us with. This goes to serve and minister to people, and let God's refining fire transform our gold and silver into justice and righteousness for a world in desperate need. And with that, let us also listen to a gift of music to be shared to us by Sister Grace Maliare.
Sing swiftly in the trees. when I look down from lofty mountains grand you and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze. When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take
Let us pray. God of power and glory, we come to your altar this morning, offering our gifts and praying for your presence in a world that is hurting and divided. Much of what we see is chaos, confusion, and anxiety, a world that desperately needs to glimpse your presence and your glory. More than just our gifts of money, we pray our lives might be a window into your love and compassion. We pray your light might shine through us to the world, O God. Amen. Again, I invite all of us to come to the Lord as we all together say our prayers to God and lots of burdens that we carry. And only when we cast our burdens to the Lord that we feel relieved. Let it be made known as well to God for the plentiful blessings we receive. We owe it all to him, and we give thanks. Let us also join the good news and not so good news expressed on the screen. Let us hear God's voice as we pray silently. My dear brothers and sisters, I would like to invite you to join me in a prayer of intercession. Our prayers are not only for ourselves, but for the church and for the community and the rest of the world. So let us follow the ones that is on the screen. Let us pray. God, we come into your presence with praise and thanksgiving for your faithful love. Your love never fails, not even we turn away from you when we ignore your invitation or desert you for gods of our own making. Even then, you do not abandon us, but reach out again and again, inviting us back into relationship once more. As you welcome us, you welcome our prayers. We bring them to you with confidence, knowing that you will hear and answer. We pray for the world you created and the people who share it with us, for countries caught up in war or violent conflict, for regions of the world struggling with increased cases of COVID-19, for those whose homes and lives are threatened by natural disaster, for these and all the other areas in our world where there is need and despair. Together, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for our country and for its people, for our government leaders, federal and local, for our judicial system, police forces, and military, for our cities, towns, and rural communities, for employers and employees, for young and old, for all who are part of this great country. Together, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for our local community, the people of our city and town, for those who are unemployed, for those in prison, for those who are hungry, for those who are alone and afraid, for all our neighbors, both known and unknown to us. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for Grace United Methodist Church and all churches who serve you, our brothers and sisters in Christ, for those who are ill or whose loved ones are ill, for those who are anxious about the future, for those struggling with their faith, for those who minister among us, for all your people in all places. Together, Lord, hear our prayer, and let us pray in unison. Pour out your Spirit on us. Fix our hearts and minds on what is true and honorable and right. Give us the joy and peace that comes from knowing and doing your will. Keep us faithful to the call we have received in Christ Jesus our Lord, extending your loving invitation to the world around us. In Jesus' name, amen. And for our closing song, let us sing the one that is on the screen.
Jesus is
go from this place with the confidence that you are God's beloved children. Go out into the world with steadfast hope and joyous trust, remembering our faithful God who goes before us. In God's love and Spirit's power and the peace of Christ, go now in peace. Amen.